And now I have the information I need to make a graph, and I need to get it into Excel. So here we have for our sound and form condition, the mean words recalled was 8.55. For meaning, it was 12.37. That is a difference. So whether it would be significant or not, we'd have to do a t-test. We're not going to do that here today. We see the mean age was 22.92 and 25.95. Here's our standard deviation, our standard error, and that's what we're going to use to make our graph. So we're going to take this information. Okay, so now we're going to get this information into Excel. So if you right click, you can copy, and I copied it as, if you see that, copy as an Excel worksheet, and then I'm going to go to my open Excel file, and I'm going to paste, and then it copies in there just perfectly, right? All the information that we need. So again, I was here, I right clicked, copy as Excel worksheet, went to my Excel, and I pasted it in. You can click here or you can control V. And I don't need all this information. So I'm not gonna do anything with age. So I'm gonna delete that column. I don't need the N here. So I'll just go up to delete again. I don't need standard deviation. I want standard error. Now the data isn't in quite the format that I need. So I need to make this my mean column, and then I need to have a standard error column. So I'm going to take my standard error, move it up there. And again, I'll delete this row. And then I'm going to, I don't need this anymore either, so I'm going to delete that row. You could just type it in if you want, if that's easier for you. I just find myself going back and forth a lot to get the numbers correct. All right, so what we're going to do here is, these are going out to too many decimal places, and we don't want that. So if we go to format cells, and we go to number, we want it to only go out to two decimal places. So there we go. So that'll make it look nice and neater. Then we highlight the information we need, just these two columns, these four cells. We go to insert, go to graph, click on the first one, and we have a graph, but it's not APA formatted. So we need to click on the chart title and delete it. Then we're going to go up here and we're going to remove the grid lines. We have our nice labels here, but we don't need this. It's irrelevant. We don't need these numbers, so we'll delete those. I do want to have an axis line there, so I click on that, and this hopefully pops up. If not, it's under chart design, formatting axis, and I'm going to go to the line portion. So if it's closed, you open that up, line, solid line. Gives you a nice line, and we want this one to be darker too, so I'm going to click on it, go over to the paint bucket if we weren't there already, go to solid line. Other thing we want to do is get rid of this outside line. So now that I've clicked on this, see how it says automatic? Let's do no line, and that line is now gone. So again, I clicked on the whole picture, it says border, it was automatic, and I've now said no line. So now we want to get standard error bars over here. So if I just again click on the graph and go up to here, say, okay, I'm going to add error bars. I want standard error. So I want them above and below, but these aren't these numbers. So now I have to click on those. I have to click on the little bar graph, and I want both up and down. I do want a cap, but I have to specify. I want to go to custom and specify my value, and then I'm going to highlight. Same thing for here. I'm going to copy and paste it here, and you can see now my error bar. So again, what I did for that was I clicked on my error bars, I went over to the graph, I scrolled down, and I click specify value. I highlighted these. You could do the same thing here. So I clicked here, highlighted there, and I have my error bars. And you can see sound and form has a smaller standard error than the meaning. And now I have my graph. So now what you're gonna do is you're gonna take all that and just put it into a Word document. That's the easiest thing to do. You can always save your SPSS as a file and send it to me. You will not be able to open it up on your computer at home on your own. I can open it up. So if you want access to it, this is the best way to do this. Or this is one way to do this. So you're gonna send me all this information. So you're gonna go click on the box, right click. We'll copy as an image. Go back to the data set and see how easy that is. Now I'm gonna go back here. I'm gonna go to my frequency table. I'm gonna copy as an image. I'm gonna paste it with Control C. Go back here. I also want this table, and then I want my graph as well. So I'm gonna go back to my Excel file, copy my graph. And this isn't quite APA formatted yet. So in order to be APA formatted, we have to type in figure one, and there's no period there. We want to put it in bold. And then we want to type down below, say means and standard error for word recall. That's our title, it's a descriptive title. We don't want it to be in bold, but we do want it in italics. All right, so that's what I'm gonna be looking for in your lab. You can, you know, put a title on the top here, put chapter 6, descriptive SPSS lab, put your name. So I'm gonna be looking for these tables and then this APA formatted figure. And again, we'll do this again later on. This is practice, but I've taken you through it and hopefully you can get an APA formatted figure, because that's an important aspect of this class.